Hello students, welcome to Saurav sir's classes. Today we are going to solve few numericals based on SAT examination. So let us begin with our very first sum. So our first sum here is based on mathematics simple calculation, but here you can see 54 by 150 not equal to. So if it was equal to, then it was a very simple sum, but here we have not equal to. So we need to consider each one of these options and check whether which of the option is not equal to this. So our first option here is 0.36. So this can be written as, we can dissolve the decimal point by 36 by 100. Now to convert the denominator from 100 to 150, what we can do is multiply this by 3 by 2. So we can multiply numerator and denominator both by 3 by 2 and we will get a 150 in denominator. So let's check what we get when we multiply 36 by 3 by 2. So 36 into 3 is 108 and divided by 2 gives 54. And 100 into 3 by 4 gives us 150. So you can see 0.36 is equal to 54 by 150. Hence, option A is not the correct answer. Now let's check option B. So option B, we have 27 by 75. So for 75 to be converted into 150, what we can do is simply multiply it by 2. So let's multiply 2 on numerator and denominator. 27 multiplied by 2 gives us 54. 75 multiplied by gives us 150. So you can see this also matches with the question. Hence option B is not correct answer. Now let's check option C. In option C we have 3 squared divided by 5 squared. So here we have 9 by 25. So for converting 25 to 150, we can multiply 25 by 6. So when we multiply 9, so we will multiply both numerator and denominator by 6. 9, 6, 54, and here we have 150. So you can see again the value is matching with our question. Hence option C is also not the correct answer. Now let's check option D. In option D, we have 3 by 5 whole square. So this is also equal to 9 by 25. Now we multiply 6. And we will get 54 by 150. Hence, option D is not the correct answer. We are left with only option E. So it may happen that option E is the only correct answer because we are left with only option E. So let's check. Here we have 3 by 5 whole cube. So 3 whole cube gives us 27. So here we will have 27. And 5 whole cube gives us 125. So 125. Now you can see in numerator we have 27. So to change numerator to 54, what can we do is multiply numerator by 2. So we'll multiply denominator by 2 also. So here we will get 54 as our required numerator, but denominator, in denominator we will get 250 and not 150. So we can say that 54 by 150 is not equal to 3 by 5 whole cube. Hence our answer to this question will be option number E. So option E is the correct answer. So let's move on to next question, that is question number 2. So question 2, here we have, if x is equal to 3, y is equal to 2, then x to the power y into y to the power x is equal to. So let's solve here. Here we have x to the power y into y to the power x. So this, here we will have x value is 3, y value is 2 into y value 2x is 3. So 3 square is 9 into 2 cube is 8. So this gives us value 72. Now let's check options. So option A is 36, which is a wrong answer. Option B, 216, wrong again. In option C, we need to calculate this. So option C, we have 3 cube into 2 square. So 3 cube basically gives us 3 into 2. 3 into 3 is 9. 9, 3, 27. Into 2 square gives us 4. So 27 into 4 gives us 108, which is not equal to 72. So option C gets cancelled out. Option D, we have 2 into 6 square. So let's solve it. We have 2 into 6 square, which is 2 into 6 square is equal to 36, which is equal to 72. So you can see it matches with our answer. Hence option D is a possible correct answer. Now let's check option E. In option E we have 6 cube by 2. So 6 cube gives us value 216. and divided by 2, it gives us value 108. So this is 108, which is not equal to 72. Hence, E is also not a correct answer. Therefore, our correct answer to this question is option number D, that is 2 into 6 square, which is equal to 72. So let's move on to the next question, that is question number 3 here. So as you can see in question 3, we have a general equation, which is x square plus 4x plus 4 is equal to 0. And we need the value of 2x minus 2. So for this equation's value, first we need the value of x. So how can we find the value of x? We need to consider the given equation, which is x square plus 4x plus 4 equal to 0. Now we can simplify this and find our value 2x. So breaking 4x into 2x plus 2x equal to 0. Now we can consider x. So we will get x plus 2, and we will consider 2 again. We will get x plus 2 equal to 0. Now we will take x plus 2 common, and we are left with x plus 2 equal to 0. So as you can see here, we have x plus 2 whole square equal to 0. Therefore, we will have x plus 2 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to minus 2. So from this, we have obtained the value of x, which is equal to minus 2. So now we can find the equation, the required equation, which is 2x minus 2. So 2x minus 2. So this will be x is minus 2. So here we have minus 4 minus 2, which gives us minus 6. So answer to this question will be minus 6. So I will like to end this video here. You will find solutions to few more numericals based on the same topic in our further videos.